4, 3, 2, 1. Hello, hello, hello. Hello and welcome. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X. And today we're going to look at a tutorial on using the projector and a welding rig. Or a 3D printer, if you want. Now, there is a few ways you can do this. You can use rotating arms. You can use other tricks. However, one of the ones that I found more efficient and I've also found better for small grid ships especially is a method that uses a welding wall, quite a small welding wall for this particular blueprint, and a piston. Now, a big shout out goes to Oldmate Abe for reminding me that really I should actually do a video on 3D printer / welding rigs, because I've never done one, and this could help people a great deal, especially if you need to bring in a little scout ship into survival. So without further ado, let's get started. First of all, let's change the color on this. I don't want a yellow block. Let's just have standard gray for today. Build 2 blocks. I'm doing this in creative to speed things up. Then build a button panel. Like that. Now you want a piston. Piston on there. Yeah, I've got my piston on here. I'm being helped by cats in the background, and by helped I mean not helped at all. Set your piston up there, and on your piston you want to slap a rotor, but you don't want to slap any old rotor. You want to slap an advanced rotor. There's a reason I like advanced rotors, because they're easier to do the naming from the start. Plus, also, you can transfer materials through them. So we're going to call this advanced rotor projector, or rather proj will do. And then we're going to come to this piston. We're going to call this piston proj, and we want to slap shear inertia tensor on that. That's me. You want shear inertia tensor on this system, and slap it on that. So we'll quickly save off. That's part one. Part two, the projector. So you'll see it's too big for the blueprint we want. So what we want to do is we want to remove that head, and we want to go onto our grid, and we want our advanced rotor projector, and we want to add a small head. Again, this is super gridding. Now you'll see that the piston at the projector is the right size. A tip on projectors: look at the picture carefully of the projector itself. You'll see it tells you how to orientate it. That's incorrect. So what we want is we want our projector face forwards like this. So if you look carefully at this, there's a plus and there is a minus. If you've done your blueprint, you will find that the plus is the top, minus is the front. Now we got that, we're ready for the blueprint. So come over to your button panel and just search for the first 3 letters of the projector, and you'll see it there. should be highlighted in a different color because it's on a subgrid. And then we want to come down to blueprints. It will open up any blueprints that you've got, and you want a small grid blueprint. For this one, we're going to use my little flying fun blueprint, the Scout Flyer 2. And now you want to go across to the blueprint on this. You want to keep the projection. And then you want to look at the forward offset, and you want to set that to about 13 for this blueprint. And then that's perfect. Okay, so now we're going to do two things. We're going to, first of all, pop our piston on here, our piston projector right here, and we're going to tell it to reverse, leave the speed as is, and let it do its thing. Feel free to hum the Thunderbirds theme, International Rescue, while it's doing its thing. This will extend out to about, well, it'll extend to 10 meters. Now, what you want to do is you want a welder. Now this, you don't want, you want it there. And if you want to know how to put welders in properly, look at the welder box carefully, and you'll see that it has this part on it. We're going to stagger welders on this one as well. So what we're going to do here is we're going to drop in a conveyor junction there and a conveyor junction there. We're then going to put in another two welders. You notice there's no actual connection there, so we could form a connection, but honestly, it's easier, really, if you're doing it like I am, to just connect everything up at the back with conveyors. Then finally, one more welder. And then just come into the back of this and pop in conveyor junctions. People usually ask me is, but how can you build in line mode? Well, while you've got a block selected, click in the right trigger, go to the build menu, and just toggle your block building modes until you've got the one you want. In this case, line, let it center, tap the right bumper, and you're good. If you're building this in survival, you'll need to pipe it up as well. Now, I'm using the heavy industry pipes. I'm not going to be overly bothered at the moment about its colour. And it's all piped in. So that's piped in to a refiner and a couple of assemblers. So in survival, you can queue up the parts you need to make this thing work. We're almost there. We'll save off again, and we'll come down to this button panel again. We're going to make a group, go into your panel, and just type WEL, get your welders. Press A on the first one, hold down the right bumper, tap A on the following ones, and then call them printer. Like so. And then hit save. Have I done that right? Sometimes at the moment with Warfare 1, there is a bit of a bug going on. That sometimes stops you from grouping things properly. Try it again. If not, we'll just turn them on manually. Very interesting. There are a few bugs with Warfare 2 even. And we'll just turn them on manually if this fails. I'm just going to call them weld to save on time. There we go. Okay. So, after a bit of perseverance on that, we will now add the welders to our thing. Now, there's one more step before we can get this to work. The welders are automatically off when you build them, so you don't kill yourself in survival, because trust me, they hurt. You need to connect the projection to the projector, and by building a block there won't work. But if I build another block, get it right there, you'll see that our ghost outline has become solid. That means that's ready to print. And now we turn on the welders, turn on the piston, and voila. One happy little scout flyer printed out of a simple welding wall. Turn the welders off. Come into your control panel to double check. Go to your projector. And you'll see build progress 104-104 complete. And then all you need to do to free your ship and make sure you blueprint your ships with their thrusters on, otherwise it will drop like a stone. And there's the flyer with the blueprint again. So what we'll do is we will just cut the grid. And there you can see the blueprint. That's ready to print again. So once more, just to show you that this is pretty cool. Welders are off. Push the piston forwards. And the current speed is 0.5. That's all you need. Just leave it on default. Works perfectly for a little wall like this. And the reason you checkerboard them is that basically it doesn't try to weld the same block twice. It cuts down on lag that can happen. I'm on a Series X, so you get very little. And then turn the welders on. Pop on the reverse of the piston. And there you go. Another happy little flyer. And that's how you can 3D print a tiny blueprint that you might have from other games to make a little flyer for your survival save. Build it in creative if you want, import it into survival with a projector, or just build something in survival, blueprint it in survival, make your projector, so if it does go boom you can at least replace it quite easily. And that's it. That's how you make a welding wall. And of course, remember, safety first. Turn off your welders, especially in survival, because you don't want to get cooked by them and they will kill you fairly quickly. Yeah, thank you for watching. Keen are working on fixing the remaining glitches and bugs that are happening with Warfare 2 and the last update. Hopefully in the next few days we'll have yet another hot fix. There's a few issues I've reported myself. Head to the support site. I'll leave the link in my video description for Keen's support site if you encounter any bugs on the Xbox. And at 15 minutes on this video, I'm going to say bye for now. Take care. Have fun. Happy engineering. Enjoy the game. There's a lot more to come. 2022 is going to be pretty big for space engineers on the PC and the Xbox. I'll see you in the next one.